way. Thank you.
I want to ask about chapter 29, yoga, not yogurt. I just can't give a tea. So wonderful. I rejected chocolate milk, perhaps better add to my life. I've scooted around the house with my legs in behind my head 2 days now. But my husband has been like an exorcist. I even put the dairy on the top shelf of the fridge so I could reach it with my legs in behind my head now. But I grew weak and start dropping it down the stairs. What can I do, Lee?
Do not fret. Shut up, you carnivore. Why don't you go gnawing and flowing like a gorilla's ass, though? Our ancestors didn't eat chicken greens. They lived at one with nature and their ecosystem, subsisting on a diet of nuts, berries, and leafy vegetables.
Yes, and they reached on their own shadow and died of old age and fear at 24.
Sad though, soul is eternal. But let me answer the question. When I'm in trouble or tempted by those all-you-can-eat breakfast buffets, and huge amounts of juicy bacon...
Can we get some bacon in here?
Never, I go back to bacon. I start the day with a fruity beverage, meditation, and 6 hours of yoga. Next, I go open up my shop, now and then, and drink 2 pints of hand-pressed tea.
And who wants a steak after that? Okay, next caller, you are on Chatterbox with Reed Tucker.
Yo, Reed, come to movie to go. How can I learn to beat up 10 guys at once?
Okay, first things first, my man. We need to stop the negative thinking. And the best attack I've found is to just run away. That way you instill fear in your opponent. You never know when you might just run from the raptors. Like a bat!
I don't want to hear about no tofu running away. I want to learn about being a legion. Is that?
Actually, I do cover this early on in the book in chapter 45. It's called Stir Fry Your Prejudice. I once fought with you before my master took me under his wing and taught me the joys of soy and origami. Concentration begins in the mind and spreads to all the extremities of the body. You must use the language of the mind, not the tongue. The language of the mind. Just look at me. I could tear a phone book in half with my bare toes. In fact, Laszlo, I could easily chop this desk in 2 half-desks.
This desk is made of 2-inch-thick composite wood pulp and has a mahogany veneer finish. It has 3 drawers, and knowing this station, it costs $100. In his own words, Reed Tucker is about to smash it into 2 half-desks. Take it away, Reed.
Ladies and gentlemen, I already visualized the desk in 2 half-desks, and now I shall make it.
Hey-ya! Oh! Ow! Oh, Laszlo! Laszlo! I think I hurt my hand if I...
He's all been wrong.
Yes, that kid. The desk is still in one piece. Thanks for coming on the show.
Okay, Laszlo, mockery means nowhere. He's my kitchen.
Oh, I breathe easily. Don't throw any tofus or bean curds at me.
Be very funny, Laszlo. It's easy to make fun of me, but it's all the fault of the phone screen here. Downright disgraceful.
Yes, it makes me talk like this.
Okay, the listener lines are open. This is Chatterbox. You're on the air.
Hey, Laszlo. That last guy was a lunatic. Where'd you dig him up from? The state? That wacko you had going on about children.
A lesson in business, my friend. If you have a unique commodity, the world and his wife will try to wrestle it from your grasp, even if they have little understanding as to its true value.
Until the sun shines, come to the earth, can't turn. feet till I drop your knees. Not to let me beat you, rock your speech. I'm trying to hold this thing.
I'm trying to take out my streak.
Run a track.
Dave Barner.
Police!
I reckon we'll be alright.
All units be on lookout for security in the Atlantic area. Suspect is armed and dangerous.
protecting someone now or just wait for it to turn black and fall off?
Give it a quick prod.
Oh, what is that gooey yellow stuff? Oh, hey, Pave!
My handyman.
I was bored, so I came over to keep Asuka company.
She's got the makings of a natural, this girl. She's managed to extract this little gem from our guest. There's a plane coming into Francis International in 2 hours' time. It is full of Catalina's poison. You can avoid airport security by getting a boat out to the runway light buoys and shooting the plane down on its approach. Collect the cargo from the debris and stash it.
Oh, you be careful now, okay, baby?
Now try the chili oil.
We'll be right back. music. Remember the clothes. Just forget about the morning after. Flashback FM.
I'm Tony on Flashback FM. Here's one for people who were so hip, if you know what I mean.
Do we technic someone now?
We'll be right back. your pizza on. Excuse me, sir. Do you enjoy your job here?
It's fun. We get to play knives.
I see. Is there a...
A revolutionary new way of saving your marriage. We understand how to give me the orchestra. With our three-step program, you'll rediscover romance guarantees.
Hi, my name's Phil. I've got three kids, two cars, and a mortgage. My love life is going stale, even before my wife's car accident.
Si, bueno. Pa' que es idiot? One of these scar-faced idiots.
The real question is, did you turn up to rescue Maria or to get me back? Well, I got news for you. Shooting you will be a pleasure, but dating you was only business. You are muy pequeñito, amigo. Throw over the cash. You have been a busy boy, but you haven't learned. I'm not to be trusted. Kill the idiot!
Solid 25. So I get out my checkbook, and the guy behind me is like, "Oh, come on, lady, you don't have $2? And I said, "As a matter of fact, I don't. I spent my last $2 last night buying gas, and it's ridiculous gas prices. Anyway, can't you see that I'm wearing my I Walk jersey? So considerate."
Oh, you'll get no argument from me. I get everything considered a moron in Liberty City. That I have no feelings whatsoever.
Exactly! Another perfect example. The other day, I'm over at the hospital to have lunch with my girlfriend, Cherie, and this maniac comes right up on my bumper, flashing his lights, and I'm like, "Hey, guys, the light is red." And says to the woman in the steel of my body, on the bus, "Please, can you believe it? I mean, who has a megaphone rigged into their car? People are so obnoxious today." And I tell my nanny, my kids can matter.
You know, I think that's a lesson to us all. All right, hello, next caller, you're on Chatterbox.
Hello, Laszlo. That woman say she was a nanny because Freddy needs a nanny because he's been a very naughty boy.
No nannies. Let's go to our next caller, all right.
Colonel James E., United States Marine Corps, 2nd Battalion. Laszlo, that caller made a really valid point. These kids today have no respect for authority, and there is one thing that will flip them into shape.
Let me guess, the military.
That's right. The military teaches you respect. Okay. These kids that thought they were going to be millionaires, look where the highway has gotten them. Nowhere. It's a dead end. Uncle Sam taking care of his boys and some girls. If more people would join the military, this would be a better country. These kids don't respect veterans. We fought for your freedom. When I came back from the Australian-American War, I didn't get a hero's welcome. I didn't get a pat on the back from my friends and neighbors saying, thanks for fighting for our freedom, Jay. After years of fighting in the trenches, I come back here and everyone's watching TV.
Now, can you tell me what this Australian-American War was? I mean, I really never heard of it.
God, not another one. Have you read a history book lately, son? The Australian-American War was the biggest war since the Big War. I tell you, I didn't do two tours and take boomerang shrapnel in my head so I can come back here and have a bunch of hippies deny history. Those Aussies are great. They wire kangaroos with a foot. Come hopping in a cage. Knock out 10 guys.
Well, thanks for the history lesson. All right, let's go over here. Hello, caller. You're on Chatterbox.
Yeah? Is that Laszlo?
Yes, it is. Who's this?
My name ain't important. It's real unimportant, okay?
No, not really. I mean, this is a radio show. People usually tell us their name.
My name is real unimportant. Hey, if you want to keep being a wise guy, you'll find out just how unimportant. Like, unimportant.
Yankee boy, it's no problem.
Want the chainsaw, gringo?
You gonna be sorry.
On fire! this thing airborne!
Going to...